Good afternoon. Welcome to our liturgy. A reminder that there is a second collection today for the church in Latin America. Please join us in singing number 432 from the Breaking Bread hymnal. Number 432. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, on this 25th Sunday in ordinary time, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for
Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that, by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
This is a reading from the Book of Wisdom. The wicked say, "Let us beset the just one, because he is obnoxious to us. He sets himself against our doings, reproaches us for transgressions of the law, and charges us with violations of our training. Let us see whether his words be true. Let us find out what will happen to him. For if the just one be the Son of God, God will defend him and deliver him from the hands of his foes. With revilement and torture, let us put the just one to the test, that we may have proof of his gentleness and try his patience. Let us condemn him to a shameful death. For according to his own words, God will take care of him." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
and by your might defend my cause. O God, hear my prayer. Hearken to the words of my mouth. The Lord upholds my life. For the haughty have risen up against me. The ruthless seek my life. They set not God up before me with their eyes. The Lord upholds my life. Behold, God is my helper. The Lord sustains my life. Freely I will offer you sacrifice. I will praise your name, O Lord, for its goodness. The Lord upholds my life.
This is a reading from the letter of St. James. Beloved, where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there is disorder and every foul practice. But the wisdom from above is first of all pure, then peaceable, gentle, compliant, full of mercy and good fruits, without inconstancy or insincerity. And the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace for those who cultivate peace. Where do the wars and where do the conflicts among you come from? Is it not from your passions that make war within your members? You covet but do not possess. You kill and envy, but you cannot obtain. You fight and wage war. You do not possess because you do not ask. You ask but do not receive, because you ask wrongly to spend it on your passions. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus and his disciples left from there and began a journey through Galilee, but he did not wish anyone to know about it. He was teaching his disciples and telling them, "The Son of Man is to be handed over to men,
and they will kill him. And 3 days after his death, the Son of Man will rise. But they did not understand the saying, and they were afraid to question him. They came to Capernaum, and once inside the house, he began to ask them, "What were you arguing about on the way?" But they remained silent. They had been discussing amongst themselves on the way who was the greatest. Then he sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "If anyone wishes to be first, he shall be the last of all and the servant of all." Taking a child, he placed it in their midst, and putting his arms around it, he said to them, "Whoever receives one child such as this in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives not me, but the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Whoever receives one child such as this in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives not me, but the one who sent me. Our Lord answers prayers in many ways, case in point, Super Bowl 54, but there tends to be two general ways in which he answers prayers. The first is he provides grace, the grace of his assistance, the grace of his sanctifying gift in life, the grace of the church and the saints and the angels, and the means by which, through him, those prayers might be rightfully, holily fulfilled. The second is he provides opportunity, the opportunity for us to participate in that grace. Thus, if we pray for patience, he will both give us the grace thereof and the opportunity to practice it. If we pray for humility, to love our neighbor, to be a better Chiefs fan, he provides the means thereof and the opportunity to practice it. The primary reason we are here at the Mass is not to receive Holy Communion. That is not, don't get me wrong, it is a great reason why we're here. I don't want you guys going back to the bishop. He was dogging on our Lord in the Eucharist. It is a wonderful reason why we're here. The Eucharist is the source and summit of our entire faith. He is God. All of it comes and flows from him. The reception of him in the Eucharist is not the primary reason we're here. If it were, then all those who have broken their hour fast, all those who are in state of mortal sin, all those who haven't received their first communion or who are not Catholic, then their primary reason for being here goes unfulfilled and empty. We are here first and foremost for the exact same reason we go to birthdays, and the exact same reason the fiancés are at their wedding day. We are here first and foremost to give ourselves away. We are here first to make a gift of ourselves to the one who loves us. Don't get me wrong, birthdays, there's so many things to receive at birthdays. Cake, ice cream, pizza, soda, fireworks indoors, and then the cops are called and no longer fireworks indoors. But if all of those external things went away and we were just in a barren desert with our friend or family whose day of birth it was, we would still be there because the first reason is to give ourselves to them in love to celebrate the gift of them. I'm here to give my love to you, you whose day of birth it is. Weddings, too. There's cake, there's ice cream, there's pizza, there's dancing, there's fireworks indoors, and then again, no fireworks indoors, and the cops are like, hey, this is twice now, Father Klein, cut it out. But if all those went away, we're still here first and foremost to give ourselves to the bride or to the groom. We're not here to first and foremost receive because we don't earn them, deserve them. We haven't won them. They can't be won. They can't be deserved. They can't be bought. We would be very poor of us to look at someone and go, I deserve you, because look at all I have done to deserve you. People aren't that cheap. Their gift of love and life isn't that cheap. We're here in front of the altar at the wedding to recognize, I could never deserve you. I could never win you. I could never earn you. You're too precious a gift and person to ever be in my capability to buy. That's why it's a question. Will you marry me? Will you make the same gift of self to me that I long to make for you? We're here to give ourselves away. That's why we're here at the Mass. We love to meet our Lord and receive him in the Eucharist. We love the community and coming together as the mystical body of Christ, unifying our prayers as one. We love seeing each other. We love listening to the wonderful music. We put up with and tolerate the really long-winded priest. But we're here first to make our gift of ourselves to him in love, because we don't earn him. We don't deserve him. We never could. It's why the satisfaction of the Sunday obligation is not the reception of Holy Communion. It's the participation in the Mass and the participation in the Eucharistic sacrifice. Love necessarily, by its essence and nature, is first gift. And if we wish to grow in it, our perspective should not be, how do I earn or gain or receive first and foremost? Our perspective should be, where am I lacking in the gift of myself to others? And how, by God's grace, can I grow in it? Moms and dads are wonderful examples of this. They give themselves freely to their children. The children will never earn it, never deserve it, the gift of life and all that comes from it. But for love of their kids, these wonderful men and women who have jobs and pay taxes and can drive and understand all the intricacies of Star Wars' great lore, they make of themselves a servant and give themselves freely to those whom they love. Teachers do the same for their students, masters for apprentices, bishops for the priests, hopefully priests for the faithful. And then we who receive that love, children, apprentices, students, the priests thereof, our joy is not to go, give me more. Our joy is to recognize this undeserved gift and ask ourselves, how do I respond? How do I give myself back in gratitude, in love? How do I show them how grateful I am for the gift of themselves by how I make that same gift of myself to them? So children are obedient to their parents, we hope, speaking as the eldest child. And apprentices and students listen and obey diligently to their teachers, priests to their bishops. We're here to give. Love is a gift. Jesus' chastisement of the apostles, as they're looking at what are we owed and due, what do we get? And the beginning of the gospel is our Lord going, I have loved you all so much, I'm going to make the ultimate gift of myself to you. I, who have given you life and freedom and all the blessings of this world, I give myself to you on the cross. And at the Last Supper, I will institute the greatest sacrament, the Eucharist, and then give myself to you in that blessed sacrament. I love you So I give myself to you. Our invitation is not to go, give me more, I'm earned it, I deserve it, I'm owed it. But in humility and righteousness go, how well am I doing, humbly and lovingly receiving the gift? And how well am I doing at returning it? We're here first to give. Husbands and wives are at their wedding day first to give, because love is a gift. We who pray to grow in love and who recognize the difficulty that that is, will be given by God two things: grace and aid to grow in it, his sanctifying gift, first flowing from the Eucharist, all the sacraments thereof, the prayers, the saints, the angels, the church, the laws, the doctrines, our neighbors, our brothers and sisters, all of it. And then second, the opportunity to make that gift to those whom we love, our brothers and sisters, our husbands and wives, our children, our neighbors, our friends, our Lord. We're here today because he is giving us the opportunity to give ourselves back to him. Let us take him up on the opportunity to make of ourselves that gift of love. Whoever receives one child such as this in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives not me, but the one who sent me.
I believe.
Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible, I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For our sin and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sin, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Trusting in the love and mercy of our Lord, let us unite our hearts and minds and bring forth to God these petitions.
For the church, may we be renewed with a spirit of fervor in carrying the word of God to those in greatest distress. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the body of the church in Latin America, may all her spiritual needs be fulfilled, especially through the calling of priests and religious. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the regions of our world most scarred by exploitation of resources and neglect, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the governing officials of our nation, may they be open to the movement of the Holy Spirit in their interior life and receive confidence in the wisdom of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for families who long for the gift of children, that their pleas and petitions be hastened to our Father's ears. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, and for those who have died from our parish this week, including Mary Gattino, Mary Chipola, Morris Smith, and Helen Byrne, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And today, we pray especially for Bill Warris, for whom this Mass is offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for the profound gift of your mercy and love. Please help us by your grace and the intercession of your saints to return the gift of love to our neighbor and to you in all that we are and all that we do. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As our gifts are being prepared, please join with us in singing number 527, Prayer of St. Francis, number 527.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never see so much to be consoled as to console. To be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, holy.
We give you praise, Father most holy, for you are great, and you have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You formed man in your own image and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death, for you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior, made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to parishioners freedom, and to prisoners freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life, and that we might know that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us. He sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits of those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. For at the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant, for when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis our Pope, James our Bishop, the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead, whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with our apostles and saints in your kingdom, there with the whole of creation, freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace.
Should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join with us in singing our communion song, number 612, The Cry of the Poor, number 612. Our next communion song can be found on page 422, How Great Thou Art, number 422.
When I look down from the
Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross my burden gladly bearing he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior. With shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art.
Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life. Through Christ our Lord.
Our announcements for this evening. Welcome to any parishioners who are back with us after an extended absence. We are glad to have you here with us this weekend. Thank you also to all who supported the second collection this weekend for the Church in Latin America. RCIA sessions, which help individuals discern and learn about entrance into the Catholic Church, begin this week. This fall, the women of St. Thomas More will be praying a rosary in the church at 6:30 p.m. on Tuesdays, ahead of the Revelation Bible study. This weekend, the St. Thomas More Green Team is collecting pill bottles and used dental and razor supplies in the narthex to be recycled. This Tuesday morning, St. Thomas More hosts a flu clinic in More Hall. Next weekend is our annual Guatemala weekend, celebrating our decades-long relationship with the peoples of Guatemala. Envelopes are available in the monthly packet to support this ongoing mystery. Eucharistic adoration continues in the church this fall from noon, 9 p.m. on Sundays. Excuse me. In honor of the year of St. Joseph, confessions will be held from 5 to 6 p.m. Sunday evenings. For details on any of these events, check out our bulletin, website, weekly email blast, or scan the QR code in the pews.
And if I may add, I would like to extend on behalf of Father Justin and our parish a sincere gratitude for all your prayers, support, and donations for St. Thomas More and the Outpaced Poverty 5K that went on this morning. If you see Father Justin, please extend to him a heartfelt congratulations. He technically won the race. It was delayed 40 minutes, and so as soon as it started, he had to finish it to go celebrate a funeral. So he got first place. So please extend that to him and let him know how proud we are of our pastor. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song can be found on page 728. Lead me, Lord, number 728.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, longing for their Lord, for God's coming kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are the sorrowing, for they shall be consoled, and the meek shall come to rule the world. Lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord. Of peace, all will call them children.